Amen. So this morning, amen. Are you ready for the word of God? Amen. How many of you love Jesus this morning? Amen. Amen. How many of you, right, you know, love Jesus so much that you're willing to impact lives? A bit quiet now. Amen. Amen. You know, are y'all ready for the word? Amen. Are you, even this morning, right, are you attentive? Amen. If I assume that you're holding your handphone, you're looking at the scripture in the handphone. Okay, yeah. Amen. And so, right, you know, just be attentive. Why? Because, you know, we've been doing a series on this whole area of we live to impact lives. Come on, tell the person next to you, we live to impact lives. We live to impact lives. Tell about three times, right? We live to impact lives. We live to impact lives. This is not just the DNA of our church. Amen. But this is the DNA of a Christian. Amen. We live to impact lives. Amen. Wherever we go, right, wherever we meet, whoever, right, you know, whatever circumstance, we live to impact lives. Amen. The only reason God's keeping us on earth is because, right, there are lives to be touched. If not, right, He might as well take us back home to be with Him, right? And what, any one of you looking forward to going to heaven? Only about 10 of us. Amen. You know, we can spend eternity with Jesus. Amen. But we are here on earth because there's a purpose, and that purpose is linked to people. Come on, say this with me, that purpose is linked to people. Come on, say it loudly, purpose linked to people. Amen. And you and I, right, you know, if we ignore people, then, right, we're not going to fulfill our purpose in God. Amen. And so we live to impact lives. Can you all just lift your hands up to Jesus this morning? Hallelujah. Lord, we pray, Father God, that even this morning, God, that indeed, Lord, for Lord, we ask God that you'll just help us, Lord. Father God, we know, Father God, this whole area, Lord, of, Lord, that even, Lord, the Great Commission, this whole area of, Father God, that even, Lord, of impacting lives, Father, this whole area of influence, God, we know, Lord, that each one of us is an influence, Lord, that even, Lord, that each one, and Lord, we want to influence people for you, God. Lord, we pray, Father God, that even, Lord, our whole, Lord, we pray, God, that you'll give us the anointing, the enablement. Father God, you'll give us, Lord, truth this morning. Father God, that help us, Lord, just to position ourselves even this morning. God, that indeed, Lord, that our lives, Lord, will be a reflection of what you want, from us, Lord. Father God, that even, Lord, this morning, Lord, if there's any issue within us, Lord, about what you want and what we want, Lord, we just want to put aside, Lord, what we want, but we want what you want. And God, even this morning, we just pray, God, for your anointing to come upon each one of us. We pray, Father God, for attentive minds, attentive hearts, and not just obedient hearts as well. And so, Lord, we just want to thank you, and we just want to give you all the praise in Jesus' name. And all the people of God shouted out, made some noise, and said, I love Jesus. Amen. Amen. Okay, about 10 of you love Jesus. Come on. How many of you love Jesus this morning? Amen. 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 And so, you know, if you guys noticed, right, you know, on the 1st of September, we did the art of connection, and we need to connect. You know, we live to impact lives. Remember, the Great Commission is God has called us to make disciples of all nations, all tribes, everybody, right? You know, whether whatever their race are, right, whatever their background, whatever their religious preference is, right? You know, everybody needs to know Jesus. So the art of connection, and then right, 22nd of September, we did right, get real in loving. Come on, we call it get real in loving, right? And you know, and sometimes we can tell people to get real in loving, but we need to tell ourselves, Suresh, get real in loving, right? You know, all of us need to have a mirror, right? And sometimes when we talk to others, we need to put the mirror and say, and we need to speak to ourselves. Amen. And so we need to get real in loving. And then, right, on the 29th of September, we looked at how are you important? And, you know, I remember, right, we looked at that scripture on John the Baptist. You know, are you a voice in the wilderness? Are you a voice? Or, you know, are we, right, just echoing, right, what the world is saying? Are we a voice, right, that's declaring what God wants us to say, right? Are we a voice, right, that's declaring who Jesus is? Or are we a voice, right? We talk about everything else, right? And, you know, and then accept, right, Jesus, right? And so each one of us is a voice. Like John the Baptist, each one of us is a voice that we prepare the way for Christ to move in our circumstances. We prepare a way for Christ to move in the lives of others. Amen. Are you a voice in your family? A lot of us, right, come from families that are not Christian. You know, are we a voice, right? Is it a voice of love? Is it a voice of concern, right? Is it a voice of healing? Is it a voice? And so we need, right? And that voice, right, is not just what we vocalize with our mouth. A voice, right, that speaks about our lifestyle. And so we looked at that. And then, right, on the 6th of October, right, we did a message in the Chinese restaurant. How many of you were there at the Chinese restaurant? How many of you remember the four-course Chinese set lunch? What was the first question? Hello? Amen. The four-course Chinese set lunch that we had. First question, very good, Tina, 10 marks for you. Amen. You know, you get the first row in heaven, you know. Okay, amen. What would Jesus do? What's the second question? Come on, what's the second question? Anyone, 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 running, running, put your hand up. What's the second question? Okay, what would Jesus do? You will be sitting next to Tina up in heaven. Okay, amen. 10 marks for you. Amen. What's the third question? What's the third question? What Jesus did at the cross. Amen. And that's important, right? Because everything that we are and live is about what Jesus did at the cross. Amen. And so, right, you know, and so we had, and so we looked at that, and you know, what would Jesus do? And you know, come on, I just want you guys right there, you know, have this habit, right, you know, in your situation, get up in the morning, what do you think Jesus would do, right? You know, when you take out your handphone, right, what do you think Jesus would do, right? You know, when you look, right, amen, at somebody, right, you're getting upset, what would Jesus do, right? Amen. You know, you look at your spouse or your children, what would Jesus do, right? Amen. You know, when you go to your works, when you go to your office, right, and you see the bulldog, right, looking at you, right, what would Jesus do? How would Jesus want us to react? Okay. And so, right, keep that in your head, right? And as we learned this last Sunday afternoon, amen, you know, at Philip D's seminar, amen, we need to reset, we need to evaluate, right? Amen. And this morning, I'm going to change the title. The title I put was, I Can Make a Difference. I'm going to change it to a question. Because the question is nice, right? Amen. And the question is, are you influencing? Are you influencing others for Christ? Are you influencing, right? You know, as you guys know, right, all of us know that everyone influences someone. I mean, this is not like, you know, PhD stuff, you know, everybody knows, right? Everyone influences someone. And you know, and the people that you influence will influence others. You know, I just, you know, as I looked at this word influence, you know, it's just very interesting, right? Those days, right, it's just, those days, right, it was just strictly, right, you say, right, you take, you know, those days we had these big dictionaries, right? You got to take it out. And then, right, as you look, right, you know, it speaks about how, you know, we affect, right, you know, someone's behavior, how we change, you know, someone. Amen. How, right, you know, by truths, right, we, you know, we bring change or we influence others. But now, right, there's a second definition of influence now. You Google it, right? It's very interesting, right? You know, over these last 10 years, right, a second definition of influence has come, and it's really linked to, you know, and when you use the word influencer, is influences a person who affects change in someone else. But now, right, there's a new definition. Influencer is also a person who's got, you know, who influence people, right, for, you know, to purchase stuff on social media. You know, it's linked to that. And so, right, that's already inculcated in the definition of influencer. And you know, in those days, right, when you think of the word influence, you think of your teacher, you know, you think of your parents, amen, you think, right, of, you know, your coach. And yet, right, you know, nowadays, right, we think of celebrities, we think of people, right, you know, the people that are following, you know, million followers, million likes, you know. And so, right, it's, you know, a different concept. And so we need to be careful, right? Why? Because, you know, Jesus wants us to be an influencer. Come on, church. Amen. We live to influence. Amen. And as I said earlier, right, you know, the only reason we are still on earth right now is because, right, you know, we have a purpose. The purpose is linked to people. You know, the Bible says, it's very clear, right, one of the signs of the end times is not, and you know, Jesus said, right, you know, when the gospel is proclaimed to all nations, and then, right, Jesus will return. And you know, and that's probably the only sign that I know that has not been fulfilled. I mean, every other sign, right, the formation of the nation of Israel, you know, everything else has been fulfilled. And so this last sign, and you know, when that is fulfilled, Jesus will return. And so our whole life on earth, amen, and as we look right at the last time, right, you know, one of the issues with us is just this whole area of lukewarmness and spiritual indifference. And we need to address it. You need to address it in your life. I need to address it in my life. Amen. But this morning, right, as we look at, are you influencing? Are you an influencer? Each one of us. And you know, the scriptures are clear. Each one of us, right, God, come on, church, you know, each one of us must realize, right, that God has called each one of us to influence. Amen. And this is, right, amen, this is, right, you know, who God wants you to be. Amen. This is, right, you know, what we are called to be, right? And you know, and this is right, as you look at scripture, right? You know, as you look at the life of Jesus, it's really very, you know, as you, the things that Jesus spoke to his disciples, it's all linked right to this word influencer. Amen. It's all linked right to this word influence. You know, when Jesus saw the disciples, right? When he called his disciples, what did he say, right? Follow me and I will make you fishers of men. That means, right, when we follow Jesus, I have decided to follow Jesus. You know, no turning back, no turning back. And so, if I decide to follow Jesus, then automatically, right, you know, as a result of that, I need to be a fisher of men. And so, fishing is about influencing wherever we go, right? You know, we need to get it into our heads. Amen. You know, on the scale, listen, not judging anybody. Amen. This is just, right, for us, right, to evaluate. Why? Because this is a serious issue. Because we live to impact lives, right? Each one of us, right? The DNA of a Christian. Amen. You know, what is within us? Why? Because Christ is within us. Amen. The DNA of every believer is that God has called us, amen, to impact lives. God has called us, right, to impart love. God has called us, right, to impact lives. That's who we are, right? Amen. And you see this, right? You know, in all the things that Jesus said and Jesus, right, you know, practiced and the way Jesus imparted it to his disciples. Amen. You know, follow me, I'll make you fishers of men. In Matthew chapter 5, amen, verses 13 to 16, what did Jesus say? Jesus, right, you know, sitting down. This was, right, you know, the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus sitting down. You know what he tells his disciples? He says this, right, you are the salt of the earth. Amen. Salt is about influence. Come on, church, you know, come on, tell the person next to you, you are salty. For those of us that pressure is not so good, maybe that's not so good, right? But you are salty in a good sense. Why? Because, you know, when you speak about salt, right, it's about influence. Amen. When you speak about salt, right, you know, those days salt was something that was precious. Your worth in salt. Amen. Sometimes, right, Roman soldiers got paid in salt. Amen. And so, right, salt preserves. Amen. Salt, right, purifies. Salt, right, adds flavor. Amen. And, you know, this is about influence. When you put salt into the food, right, it influences the food. Amen. The food, right, you know, whatever you cook, right, you know, and without salt, with salt, right, it influences, it tastes better, it adds flavor. Amen. And so, right, Jesus said, right, you are the salt of the earth. Amen. And then, right, he says, right, you know, come on, he uses some strong words, right? You know, the last message was some strong words as well, right? What did Jesus say to the church in Laodicea? Hello? Anybody remember? I will spit you out. Wow, Jesus. Amen. You know, Jesus said, right, you know, this is not like game time. This is not like mediocre Christianity. This is not like, you know, I do it because if I feel like doing it, I'm doing it. This is serious stuff. And Jesus says here, right, if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. And so, right, this whole area of salt. Come on, you are the salt of the earth. And then Jesus, right, moved on, right, and said this, right, you are the light of the world. Amen. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Verses 15 and 16. Nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all those who are in the house. And then in verse 16, let your... Come on, shout it out. Let your so, amen. Is your light shining? Are you shiny, 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 shiny? Very shiny. Praise God, Cleola. Amen. Amen. Is your light shining? Amen. How many of you want to sing that song? What's the song? This little light of. Hello, everybody. How many of you know that song? This little light of mine, let it shine. Amen. And then, right, you know, and the Bible says that we cannot put the light into a bushel. Amen. We need to shine. Amen. This light, right, you know, as Christians, come on. There are no Christians that live in isolation. A Christian, right, as soon as you receive Jesus, right, you are like that city put up, right, you know, for people to look at, right, and when people look at, right, you know, people, right, must realize this is, right, we get attention, right, for Jesus, right, amen, we are placed, amen, when you and I, right, had a light, amen, it is not for us to put it under the sea, come on, you know, you never go into a building and see lights on the ground, right? Amen. Lights are always up. Why? Because it needs to shine. Amen. It needs to remove darkness. Amen. That's why, right, you know, we are, God has placed us, you know, God has said, right, not that we are called to be lights, but the Bible also says you are lights. Amen. For you, right, to be a light, it is part of our Christian nature. Amen. Because the Bible says you are, not that you become, you are. Amen. And if you and I are not lights, that means, right, we are not, you know, we are not behaving in who we are in Christ. Amen. Because we are, amen, as long as Christ is in us, you are the salt and you are the light. Come on, church, you know, that means, right, you are an influencer. Amen. That means, right, when you use the word influence, that means, right, you are a person, right, you know, to influence people for Jesus. It's all about people. It's all, come on, you know, God gives you a job because it's about people. Amen. God, you know, puts us together in a church because it's us, people. Amen. And where we are is because of, you know, who people have influenced us. Amen. And if you look at your life, you look at my life, it's all about how people have influenced us in a good way or bad way. But we all influence us. And you see, right, each one of us influence, right, is about people. Influence, right, it's about bringing change, right? And of course, right, when you think of influence, you know, and sometimes we get discouraged, right? You know, Pastor, I've been praying for this person doing well. But sometimes the results are not instantaneous, are not so obvious. But listen, people of God, right, you and I, right, do not judge, right, the harvest. Amen. Why? Because, you know, sometimes when you influence, and the roots are already in there, and one day we will reap the harvest. You know, the other day, some of you know, I was sitting in my second office. Where's my second office? The staff know. First office, CD 5-13. Second office, the mama shop downstairs. A lot of ministry takes place there, right? You know, sometimes you'll just be amazed, right, in a relaxed atmosphere, over a cup of tea, right, a lot of things, breakthroughs take place, right? And I was just sitting there, we were just talking, right? Then a lady pops up and says this, right? Are you a pastor? I said, yes. Where's your church? We were just sitting there, right? Because that's where we... And then, you know, she said, right, she's going to... she will make an attempt to come to church. And she works in one of the shops there. You see, friends, you know, everywhere we go, right? You know, just a few days ago, I stepped out of the office. And I know, right, before we leave CT 5-13, I need to share the gospel with one of the people there. The Lord said, son, you've got to share the gospel. And, you know, and you need to make, you know, that this person... Because we've developed a friendship. Once you develop the friendship, we earn the right to present the message. Amen. You see, right, you know, once people are comfortable with the messenger, you are the messenger, I am the messenger. And then, right, we earn the right to present the message. And so, right, you know, sometime, you know, the next few days, next 1 or 2 weeks, right, I need to see how, right, to present the gospel to one of these people on the same floor. You see, right, we live to impact lives. Come on, church, you know, each one of us. Amen. You have no idea, right? You know, one word of encouragement, how that word can change someone. You have no idea, right? How one act of kindness can change someone. Amen. You know, one act of kindness, right? May just mean, right, us doing something, right? You know, but it may be different, right? You may be, right, eating, you know, something, right? You may be eating, and then you see a poor man on the other side, right? And, you know, and then you go and pay his bill. One act of kindness, right, may make a difference in somebody else's life. Amen. Come on, one moment of love. Amen. You and I, right, you know, one moment of life, right, can change, right? It's amazing, right, what God can do with each one of our lives. One smile that you have. Amen. One smile that you have, right? Maybe on the lip you smile, you're friendly, right? Could change somebody else's life. You know why? Because nobody smiles, right? And, you know, and that smile, right, you know, later on you smile a few times, then you develop the relationship. Come on, church, you know, one gift that you give. Amen. You know, one gift that you give, right? You know, look out for opportunities. Amen. You know, just one smile can change something. One moment of expression. And you and I have no idea, right? Why? Because out there, people are desperate for love. Out there, right, people are looking for, you know, people are looking for answers. And you may be the answer that someone needs. Come on, church. You know, every person, come on, church, every person, right, is a miracle to happen. Can I hear an amen? Come on, help me with this, right? Every church, right, is a every person, right, is a miracle to happen. Amen. Why? Because they do not know Jesus. Why? Because they are in deep trouble. Some of them, right, struggling at home. amen, putting on a smile at their workplace and struggling, right, at their home, marriages breaking up. You know, some of them, you know, really struggling with things in life. And you may be the answer, and God has placed you there. Hello? God has placed you there. Amen, that we will live to impact lives. Are we influencing? Come on, each one of us, right? You know, this morning, you know, I think 3 weeks ago when I spoke on, are you important? I used 2 Kings 5 about, you know, that Jewish slave girl. You see, sometimes when you read scripture, right, you know, we put ourselves in the lives of these people. And how, right, this Jewish slave girl, amen, a victim, right, you know, ministers to the person that caused the misery, right? How? This is the grace of God. And as a result, that Naaman, you know, experienced his healing. But today, right, I just want to run through, amen, another exciting portion of scripture. If you and I, right, want to do evangelism, amen, every evangelism presentation, amen, whether it's John 3:16 or evangelism explosion, amen, or the 1 minute, you know, presentation, amen, you know, it, you know, people, you know, when we do an evangelism, you know, sharing or a presentation, amen, you know, every person that does this has to learn the principles from Jesus in John chapter 4. And so, right, in John chapter 4, amen, we're just going to look this, but this morning, you know, one of the people in scripture that intrigues me, right, one of the people in scripture that, you know, fascinates me, amen, one of the great influences in scripture, right, as you look at this, right, was this Samaritan woman. You know, and as we do, as we go through this journey, amen, come on, if this Samaritan woman can be an influencer for Christ, you and I can be an influencer of Christ. Can I hear an amen? Amen. So John chapter 4, I mean, we don't have time to go read through all the scriptures, but Jesus, right, you know, was getting out of Jerusalem, Judea, and he was making his way up north to Galilee. And then the Bible says, come on, someone say the Bible says. When the Bible says something, we need to take note. And the Bible says Jesus needed to go through Sychar. Amen, in Samaria. And so, right, Jesus makes this journey through Sychar. And as he makes this, right, you know, they believe that Sychar was the new name for the old name Shechem. Amen. And so, right, he comes here and Jesus is at the well. Amen. As he's at the well, amen, as you learn from Jesus, right, you see, right, how Jesus presents the message. And then, of course, right, we're going to focus on how this lady responds. And then he sits there. It's 12 o'clock in the afternoon. He's tired. He needs a drink. A lady comes up. Lady coming up at 12 o'clock. Come on, there's something wrong down here, right? Because no lady will go to the well at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Most of them, right, in the evening, the cool of the evening. And so this lady comes up. So, right, you know, she really is a social outcast. Hello, who is she? She's a social outcast. And later on, right, we realize she's been through 3-5 marriages, and the guy that she's living now is not, you know, she's not married to him, so she's in an adulterous relationship. Come on, she is messed up, right? Amen. She, amen, you know, as far as the people are concerned, amen, she is immoral, she's messed up. Amen. She, and you know, as you look at her life, come on, we, yes, you know, she's messed up, but you and I will never know, right, you know, what caused the messed up. Maybe, right, the guy that she married first messed up. Maybe, right, she was, right, in a relationship and she got pregnant. Maybe, right, she had an abusive father. Come on, and people get messed up. Amen. People get messed up, and sometimes it's not because of them. Sometimes they're a victim of their circumstances. You know, many years ago, you know, a lady came and saw us. And, you know, and she looked and she was really in bad shape. She was mentally unsound. And she was really, you know, struggling in a marriage and everything, right? Her marriage was going through a divorce. And then she told us a story. And her story was this. She came from an abusive father. Amen. Her family was dysfunctional. And, you know, and she told herself, right, as soon as I reach 18 or 19, I'm out of this, right? As soon as I finish from 5, I'm out of this family. I'm going to KL, right, to live my life. And so within her, right, you know, all she wanted, why? Because her house, her family was dysfunctional, abusive, and so, right, she wanted a way out, and so she came to KL. And, you know, and so she wanted love, and what did she do, right? Amen, she was looking for a relationship to get into. And so she was pretty normal before she got into this relationship. But once she got into this relationship, the guy that she married was messed up, and he was mentally sick. And so, right, you know, the marriage went through hell, and the marriage broke up. And after this, right, you know, she comes out, right, divorced. And again, now she is messed up, right? She is mentally, right, you know, ill, right? And then she feels, right, you see, right, people are looking for love. And, you know, people always look for love, right, in another human being. Come on, the answer is Jesus Christ. Can I hear an amen? He is the way maker. He is the promise keeper. Amen. He is the light in the darkness. And He is the one. And so, right, you know, she comes out of this relationship, and now she thinks maybe the second guy that I marry, right, will make a difference. And now the second guy that she got married to was a nice guy. Amen. But when this guy got married to her, she was messed up. And then, right, you know, when they got married, right, now, right, he becomes messed up as well, right? And when both of them came to see me, he said, Pastor, I can't imagine, right, that I've got thoughts to kill my wife. And so, as a result of that, both of them, right, gave their hearts to Jesus. And of course, right, I've lost touch with them. You see, right, when this woman came, man, she was messed up, right, been through 5 husbands, you know, now, right, living in an adulterous relationship. And, you know, and look at the way Jesus addresses her. Jesus addresses her with honor and respect. Question. Amen. Come on, he moves, right? He moves, right, from the natural, amen, and then he moves to the spiritual. Come on, say this with me, right? He moves from the natural, and then he moves to the spiritual. And so he asked him, I need a drink, right? The lady, right? Wow, she said, right? You a Jew asking me, a Samaritan for a drink? Amen. You know, Jews hate Samaritans. Amen. So Jews, right? You guys, right? Call us dogs. Amen. And you are wanting a drink from me? You, a man, a Jewish rabbi, wanting a drink from me, a Samaritan woman. And so she is confused. Amen. But as a result, that means she gives a drink. Then Jesus goes on, as a result of this conversation, Jesus goes on to reveal himself. Come on, church, man. He moved from the natural to the spiritual. He said, right, I am the one who gives water, living waters, bringing forth for everlasting life. The woman stretches her head and tells him, but you know, where you going to get, you know, you've got nothing to take from the well. And then Jesus reveals himself. And then, right, Jesus reveals, right, that Jesus asks her a question. And then Jesus reveals her spiritual need. And then, man, she's so, right, and then, right, they move into a conversation on worship. And then Jesus reveals himself, right, as the Messiah. Amen. And then, of course, right, at that point, the disciples come. And these guys, right, you know, are looking, they say, Jesus, have you eaten your food? These guys, right, are looking at Jesus, Jesus is talking to a woman. And so, right, as they are talking, right, we were going to read this, because this is an amazing scripture. Come on, slap somebody in the back, right, and say, amazing, get ready for this, right? Get ready for this. Why? Because, you know, an intriguing scripture, a great scripture on influence. Look at this. John chapter 4, verses 28-30. Right? Are you ready, Elam? Hello, everybody. Come on. Are you ready this morning? Let's read this, right? Then the woman left her water pot, went her way into the city, and said to the men, come and see a man who told me all things that I ever did. Could this be the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came to him. Amazing, right? Hello? Am I the only one that's finding it amazing? Right? What do you think, right? Come on, someone say amazing or something, right? Amen. You all are too quiet. Amen. You need to help me preach this. Amen. Amen. What did she do, right? She left her water pot. What did she do? She went her way into the city. And what did she do? She opened her mouth and she said to the men, come see a man. Come see a man that changed my, you know, come see a man that has made an impact upon my life. Amen. Come see a man, right? You know, I've experienced this man. And then she says this, right? A man who told me all things that I ever did. And then she just put this question, could this be the Christ? What happens to this, right? What was their response? Amen. The Bible says, right, they went out of the city and came to him. Reading from verses 39 to 42. Read this together. Let's read this. But many of the Samaritans of the city, come on. Many of the Samaritans of the city believed in him because of the word of the Lord. Come on. Many of the Samaritans believed in him because of the word of the Lord. Come on. She was no celebrity, right? She was a sinner. Amen. She was sinful. Amen. You know, she was, you know, immoral before the point, right? She met Jesus. Amen. She was a social outcast. And, you know, and she, as you look at her, right, you know, you would think, man, this lady is not going to be an influencer, right? But what did she do? Amen. The Bible says, right, because of her, amen, many of the city believed in the word, because of the word of the woman who testified. And all that I ever did. So when the Samaritans had come to him, they urged him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 more days, and many more believed because of his own word. Then they said to the woman, now we believe, not because of what you said, for we ourselves have heard him, who we know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world. Come on, church, you look at her, right? You know, a great influencer, right? How many of us here, right, have brought a city to Jesus? How many of us here? You know, how many of us, right, if you look at the church, amen, of the worldwide, right, of how many people in the world, right, have brought cities to Jesus? Come on the scale of 1 to 10, right, on this area of influencing Christ, where would we place ourselves? Amen, please, not to judge anybody. Why? Because we've got to get real, right, each one of us. Amen, we've got to get real, right, of what God wants from us. We've got to get real, right, why we are living. You know, we got to get real, right? You know, why there's still breath in our life. We got to get real, right? And why, right, we do church. And what's church for? We got to get real, right? On why, right, God's given us, right, families. You know, why we have friends, neighbors, network of relationships. On the scale of 1 to 10, where would you place yourself? Of course, right, you know, 10, I think none of us would place them. Maybe 10, right, a guy's like Billy Graham, Reinhard Bonnke, you know, some of these guys, right? Of course, right, 1, none of us would place that, right? But, you know, if you say, right, you know, from 7 to 9 or 7 to 9, right, you know, people, right, that are conscious, you know, people, right, that are praying every day, right, for the salvation of people, right. One of the things I've done, right, on my notes on my phone, right, I've put all the names of, you know, people that I know, right, are not saved, right. And, you know, we've got to be intentional. Hello? Influence is intentional. Of course, influence is also unintentional. When we and the staff, right, are there, you know, sometimes the evenings, right, doing the tea, amen. You know, there is an unintentional influence because people are watching. That a girl could come, step up and say, are you a pastor? Are you Christians? Can I come to church? That's unintentional. But you and I have got to be intentional in influencing. Amen. And so, right, you know, come on, from 7 to 9, right, you know, people, we are praying, amen, we are looking for opportunities. Or maybe, right, from 2 to 4, right, our people that, you know, don't have no interest, right, in, you know, don't even pray, right, no interest. And of course, a lot of us will be from 5 to 6 or 7. Right? Come on, church, this is the DNA, right? This is everything, right, that Jesus commanded us for. Amen, this is what we are called for. Why am I preaching this? Why am I screaming this out, right? Why? Because this is the message, right? This is our DNA. This is our very existence, right? Because we have no idea what one word of encouragement could change somebody's life. We have no idea, right? Even this morning, right? One expression of love. Amen. We have no idea, right? One smile on, you know, one smile, right, could change. Or one hug, right? We have no idea, right? One act of kindness. Amen. One act of kindness, right? You know, maybe, right, you know, your neighbor, right? You know, one act of kindness. Amen. You know, and of course, right, you know, every you have no idea what one act, right? You know, God can use this act, right? And bring the salvation of someone. Amen. You see, these are people that are waiting the miracle. Going back to this scripture, get the worship team out now. Then the woman left her water pot. And then, right, the Bible says, right, in verses 38 to 40, went away into the city and said to the men, come see a man who told me all things that I ever did. Could this be the Christ? Then they went out of that city and came to him. Friends, this morning, an immoral woman just experienced Christ. Sinful, social outcast. And what did she do, right? Come on, she didn't have the opportunity to go for seminar on evangelism training. Evangelism training, and we'll be having our evangelism training in November. And you guys need to sign up. All of us here, come on, all of us here need to know how to share the gospel, lead to people to Jesus, and disciple people. This person here, right? Come on, looking at, you know, all the people that were there, right? Come on, you know, she had a social outcast. Man, when guys looked at her, right, they would look at her, wow, man, she's hot. Ladies, when they look at her, right, they would look at their husbands and looking and making sure the husbands have no association with this lady, right? Come on, she was, and you know, when she came and gave this message, she was still in a relationship. Amen. And you know, and of course, right, she had to address it later on. She was still in a relationship that was wrong. But she was an influencer. Come on, church, look at me. You know, some of us, right, you know, you know, God uses imperfect people. Are you imperfect this morning? Come on, I'm imperfect. You know, we all make mistakes, but God uses imperfect people. God uses, right, you know, a messed up person here. A messed up, seriously messed up. But what was, why did she become such a great influencer? Right? She experienced Jesus, right? She experienced Jesus. Jesus, right, spoke into her life. Jesus, right, revealed himself to her. Jesus, right, addressed her spiritual needs, right? And when she had that experience, right, the next step was, what did she do? I was just wondering, right? You know, the Holy Spirit puts this here. She left her water bottle. I mean, the scripture could have just said, right? She went away into the city, right? But what was it, right? What is God trying to tell us, right? That she left, you know, she had an experience with Jesus. And then, right, she goes and walks into the city. And the Bible says she left the water pot. You know, and I really feel, right, believe, right, that water pot speaks about, right, you know, we are so concerned about our water pots. Amen. We are so concerned about our concerns and our things, right? And sometimes, right, you see an experience. Yes, you know, you see, right, it's not just about you and me, right? It's about him and them. Come on, say this with me, right? It's not just about you and me. Like. Come on, talk to me, everybody, right? It's not just about you and me, right? It's about him and them. Come on, say this with me, right? It's not just about you and me, right? It's not just about you and me, right? It's about him and them. Amen. It's about him. It's about him. It's about him. And you and I are so concerned, right, about our silly water pots. You and I are so concerned, right, about our own stuff. Amen. You and I are so concerned, right, about things, right? Yes, you know, water pots are important, carries water, right? But, you know, our priority, right, this morning, there's a city, there are people that need to be reached. And so, right, as you look at this, right, the experience, and then, right, you know what you see, right? You know, as you just picture this, right? You know, she experiences Jesus, leaves the water pot, and then how does she go and see the city, right? What do you think? What do you guys think, right? You know, I'm sure, right, she'll be running like that. Hey, come and see, right? Come and see, come and see, right? Come and see, come and see, come and see, right? The man who told me, right, things about myself, come and see, right? Could this be the Christ? Could this be the Christ? Could this be the Christ? This, amen. You know, and there was an excitement in her being, right? Excitement, right? Come on, when we talk about Jesus, there's no greater excitement than Jesus. Amen. There's no greater fulfillment, right, than Jesus. And we got to be excited, right? You see, right, the message, our influence. You know, if you're excited about something, people will listen to you. Right? I mean, if you're excited about something, right? You know, the world, right, people are excited about crazy stuff. And amidst that, there are followers that are following them. Amen. No, but let's be excited, right? And then, right, there was an explanation. And we must always be willing. Come on, look eyeball to eyeball. All of us, right, must always be ready and willing to give an explanation about Jesus. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. All of us, right? Each one of us, don't shy away, right? Because you are the salt of the earth and you are the light. Come on, stand up with me this morning.